I'm Dr. Esme Schaller. I'm a clinical psychologist and I'm an associate clinical professor at UCSF in the Department of Psychiatry. I'm here to talk with you about crisis survival skills that you can use to bring your body chemistry back down again so that you can face another day in this pandemic. We're all in a crisis right now, and our bodies get really tired being in a crisis for a very long period of time. And you may find sometimes that your emotions get so high and your body chemistry gets so overwhelmed that it's hard to think straight. This may be when you're just really keyed up because of everything that's going on. It may be because you're literally having a panic attack, or it may just be in bed at night and you can't wind down, you can't de-stress from the day that you've just had. So I'm here to teach you four skills. These come from dialectical behavior therapy, which is my specialty, and it's a treatment that was originally made for people with really chronic emotional dysregulation, a lot of suicidal thoughts, and who just have a really hard time in general. But these skills can be used by anyone to get through a really difficult moment. So there's four of them, and they spell out TIPP. We're gonna tip your body chemistry, T-I-P-P. But the T is actually my favorite, so I'm gonna do that one last. The I stands for intense exercise. Of course, we all know exercise is good for us, right? But this isn't exercise like every day, get some exercise for your general health. This is outrunning your anxiety. So you're already really, really, really keyed up. Dive into it. Do as many push-ups as you can in 5 minutes. Do as many jumping jacks or burpees as you can. Run around your block. Intense burst of exercise to sort of bring your body in line with where your mind and your physiology are to help reduce the anxiety and wear yourself out. The first P stands for paced breathing. And this is a way to activate your parasympathetic nervous system instead of your fight or flight reflex in a slower way. You may have heard of it called box breathing, something like that. There's a lot of variations and you can do different counts. The idea is counting your in-breath, a hold at the top, and then your out-breath. I find it most helpful to make each one a little bit longer than the last. So I often do a 4, 5, 6. Let's do that one together really quickly. We're gonna breathe in for 4. Hold for 5. And then out for 6. You keep doing that in a pattern. It down regulates your whole body. It's really helpful. You can do it smaller. You can do 4, 4, 4. You can do longer, 4, 7, 8, whatever works for you. The fourth one is progressive muscle relaxation. And this is where you tighten your muscles purposely and then relax them and notice the difference. So often you'll tighten your fists as tightly as you can and hold them for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then relax your hands and feel the difference between holding and tightening. I can't do this one on my own. My mind wanders, I start thinking about other things I was anxious about, and I get off track. So if that's you, there's links for both paced breathing and progressive muscle relaxation under this video. You can listen to other people walk you through a whole body scan. Great way to help with your sleep at night and just, again, rewrite what's happening in your body in that moment. But if you're really at the top of your trajectory, fight or flight is in full effect, you can't think straight, you can't feel straight, you don't even know what you're feeling, I really like to use temperature. There's some caveats with this one. Those are in the comments as well, or in the text under this video. You shouldn't use this if you have a heart problem or a history of an eating disorder, or if you're pregnant. But if you're not, here's what you do. You get a bowl full of ice and water. You can see I'm outside, so some of my ice is already melted, but I promise you it's really, really cold. And you take a deep breath and you put your face in it for as long as you can stand it, 10 seconds or so. Woo! I feel different already. I'll tell you right now. And I demonstrated that because it's one that people often don't want to try because it seems so crazy, but it really works. I'm already feeling my body calm down. If you think about if you actually fell in the ocean and were drowning, you would need to be calm and centered to solve that problem. And that's what this does. That's what tipping your body chemistry with temperature does. Call it an ice dive, you can call it the dive reflex. It's really, really helpful. And I hope you'll try one or all four of these things to get through this challenging time. Thanks.